Welcome back, guys, to the next part of Starfox Adventures Dinosaur Planet, and you join me straight back after the extreme. What are you trying to do, machine? Don't try to steal my barrel. I worked hard to get this barrel. You join me after the extremely frustrating 5-minute walk up one spiral. Oh, come on. Is that... I might just cry now. I'm not even kidding you. I might just cry. Did that seriously just happen? Did some guy with a cannon just blow up the barrel that I spent ages trying to get up last episode? Does the barrel not even reappear? Game, seems like you set this out to make me cry. And you might have succeeded. Is there any way to get the barrel shortcut up? I want another barrel. Do I have to bring up the barrel all the way again? You do not know how much this is... I might have to, like, just go insane right now. Slide down. Barrel does not respawn. I have to literally go all the way back down and bring the barrel back up again. So after thinking I'd finally done it last episode, it's time to go through hell yet again. I cannot believe this. Had to be a guy with a cannon, just like there, like, yeah, gonna get you with my cannon. Right, this might prove to be the hardest segment in the entire game. Or at least the most baffling for me. If I break down and cry anytime during this, I'm sorry. I just couldn't take it anymore. It looks like I'm going to get up here 2 times in a row now. Yep. Is there an easier way to do this? I don't want a guy with a massive cannon coming after me. It's very inappropriate, let's put it that way. Well, I kind of missed that, didn't I? Here, take it. Okay, we got it first time again, but the whole getting past the big cannon guy, that looks going to be irritating. Oh my god. And he's still bombarding me even here. I'm going to have to try and go forward and see if there isn't a way to get... Oh, I can't get rid of him. As you can see, there's a bridge I have to raise to get rid. So essentially, I have to keep moving and avoid the flames and blow up this wall. Well, I bet there's no guarantee that when I hit the wall, it'll actually blow up in the end. Because, you know, that's what this game... It feels like that game's doing that to me right now. It feels like it hates me so much. It doesn't want me to succeed. Okay, I'm going all the way around this way. I wish you had some kind of maximum range that was... just so much further away. Obviously, this is a safe way to go because we have a gigantic wall in the way, which kind of helps. Now, can I put the barrel down and then blow it up? No, I have to throw it. Don't worry, I hit it. Good. We know no more barrel shenanigans anymore. Oh my god. What an absolutely irritating segment of game. But it wasn't fake difficulty, like I said, that was just actually difficult for me. For no reason at all. I nearly died, in fact. So, I opened up the platform below, but not the platform to get to that guy and sort him out. And now I'm on fire. Which is all proving to not be very handy. Is there any way to get up to, like, kill that guy? Because he's just irritating the crap out of me. I need that cannon. Because if you look over there... it's something to hit. That's interesting. So I do need that cannon. Slide down. Yeah. Ugh. Let's just get over what just transpired in the last 8 minutes or so of gameplay. Ugh. No more stressing me out, game. No more. Bye-bye, boulder. Is there any way, anything this way? There's a whole room this way, in fact. Where does it actually lead? Does it lead to anywhere nice? Well, at least another switch. It's never bad. Is that the switch to get to the cannon? Okay. And is that puzzle complete fanfare that's going on now different than before? Oh, look. You can't go this way, wall. You're not going this way. No way. We're just going to be blackness. Blackness means no. So we can head up this way. But first of all, let's get the cannon. Mainly because I have to say, I want revenge. I want it to die. I want to kill that guy so badly for putting me through so much mental anguish up to this point. I think he just deserves to die. And I hope you guys don't mind with that fact. I've never felt this way before about a computer game minion. It's just a minion. It's not even a boss. But he must die. There is no way in hell this guy is living. He doesn't deserve to live. He's gonna get... I'm gonna stylish attack him. Twice. Oi. That wasn't the stylish attack. There we go. Suck it! I hate you. Never come back. Okay. So we have this to blow up for no reason. Okay, that open part of a platform. So this is actually what I'm supposed to be doing. There's not just a randomly kill guy. It really is, I actually needed to go there. Which is always good when you're... when your personal goals go together with your abject hatreds, let's put it that way. If my personal goal is to abjectly kill that guy and kill him as much as possible, but it gets me further in the game in the progress, can't say, it's just win. I will be thankful to never see this room ever again. Except when I go back watching videos. I was talking to a friend about how these videos are very, very interesting, especially doing daily Let's Plays, because, I mean, I'm 26 now, I mean, I've been with my other half for a good 7-8 years, and I was, oh, I need to go up, and I was thinking how interesting this is for many, many different reasons of having kids and having all these gameplays. I was just thinking, like, for example, worst case scenario, which is like, I don't even know why this one was mentioned. I can't get across. That was a good mechanism for dodging. I'm going down. I've decided I'm going all the way down. Oh, that looked brutal. Oh, Tricky's back. Hi, Tricky. Did you just see me break my neck? And the flamethrowers have decided they don't want to work anymore. They're on an off day, it seems. I just want to get down on the ground as fast as possible, so that's why I took the swan dive. But, the interesting thing about having all these videos up is, like, for example, even on a worst case scenario, which is, like, I don't even know why this one was brought up when we were talking. Say, for example, I coughed it. It's a nice video diary or something to, like, get them to know their dad. Kind of interesting. Or say, for example, I needed something to entertain them. I mean, say I was too tired to do a bedtime story. There you go, it's a video. Probably not the best kind of parenting in the world, but it's interesting. It's like a document of me in the past. Something I can show my kids when I grow up and say, I did YouTube, mate. Pretty lame, but whatever. It's really interesting what this video is in a sense, a video legacy I leave behind. I thought coming down here would lead me to wherever that platform was. Ah, it does. It's over there. Lovely jubbly, and we can move on with the game and stop talking about random stuff. But that looks like a Krazoa Spirit altar, I have to say. Are we at a Krazoa Spirit? Of course, Fox doesn't really know what Krazoa Spirits are yet, does he? So that's an interesting thing storyline-wise right now. Boss Galdon? Okay, that's not what I was expecting. Tricky's already here, look. He's just there in the background. Okay. We've got a frozen guy in a molten lava place, which doesn't make sense. And he's got the spellstone in his hand. So we're going to melt him, and then we're going to engage him in mortal combat. I love how Tricky's so confused.
He's got the spellstone!
Oh, lovely. Nice faces. I gotta say though, did he really have to eat it? That just makes my job more difficult. Run away from green blobs. That's lesson one we've learned. Where to attack, how to attack. Does that fire do anything to him? Tricky's just getting blasted. Is there anywhere to attack him? Well, he doesn't like Tricky. What's with that? Ah, he's a weak spot on his tail. Literally, we're going under. Oh, we can't go under. So while he's busy attacking Tricky, we sneak up behind him. Oh, his tail just stabbed me once. I hit him in the ass. Doing a lot of that recently. Bosses in games. Oh, that's not very good. Now I'm in his stomach. And what seems to be a tonsil inside his stomach. Okay, the green things are bad. Keep away from the green digestive microbes. I think we've made him puke. Lovely. And if he eats you whole, then... Ooh! We have some kind of new weak spot. I don't want to be standing still like that. So are we shooting it? Oh, we did punch her then. I'm not sure. It seems like we have to be in a certain range. And then again, we have to be out of a range as well. Because I think we just got completely totaled by this boss. Oh my god, I didn't even see what was going on there. This is just episodes of Calamity right now. Tricky, do something useful. I'm not sure how we lost so much health so fast. I see the obvious weak spot, but getting out of the way while using the staff to hit it in the appropriate manner doesn't really work. In fact, it just seems like most of the time it just hits around it and doesn't hit it, even when it hits it, you see? Do I actually use Tricky for something? Would that be a good idea? Oh my god, these balls of doom! I'm so lucky I have these Befondad guys. Huh? I'm out of energy again. I need a plant. This boss has a crazy strategy to it. It's a lot harder than you would have thought. What happened there? He just refueled or something? Oh, he's down to 2 hearts, so I obviously did some damage then. So have I just got hit it? Have I got to hit it a certain time? Okay, we just wasted him. Good. He's leaking. And now he's at me again, because Fox didn't learn from the first occasion. So that makes perfect sense. It sounds like even Fox took in some gastric juices of his own then. Beat it up. Oh, damn you, green things. Here we come with a pukin. Oh, oh, did we get it? We got a spellstone. Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
Massive case of heartburn. What an interesting way to die.
Oh, you must forgive your father. You must work together to lead the Snowhorn tribe against Scales instead of fighting each other.
I will, Fox. Because of you, my people shall no longer live as slaves.
Okay, we'll see you soon. We gotta take this spellstone back to the planet.
And we gained a health bar there, it seems. So yeah, that boss was a lot harder than I would have thought. We died for the first time in the game. I haven't died in any Let's Plays yet, apart from the Castlevania one, which is kind of hard not to at times, because it was a hard mode playthrough. But I haven't died in... I didn't die in Lilac Wars, didn't die in Skyward Sword. First time I died. Pretty monumental, I think. But yeah, random. It was actually harder to hit that boss than I would have thought. I mean, the weak points weren't obvious until it literally showed me the tell one. I mean, otherwise you'd expect to fight it head on. Randomly, it took all my health in no time at all. Maybe I stood on a flame grate. I'm not quite sure of that. But apart from that, it was just really, really random fight. It was so hard to hit that middle chest partition. I mean, you saw me shoot it so many times, and it just felt like it didn't do anything. Let's go back over to the planet and deposit this spellstone. Cool little steps there. Our wings seem better days though. I know it's a fighter pilot, so it's never going to be like completely and utterly pristine. It's always going to be scratched and stuff, but still. It's kind of in the same state of disrepair looking as the Great Fox was.
Great job, Fox! You saved the Snowhorn tribe and collected the spellstone. But it's not over yet. You need to return the spellstone to the Force Point Temple. Happy has indicated that it is located beyond Moon Mountain Pass. I'm sure the Thorntails can point you in the right direction. Pepper out!
Let's go! We only need one ring. Let's try to go for all 10 though on this flight through. Okay. Not sure if I should focus on killing things or gold rings. Can't destroy the big boulders, the annoying thing. So when you want to get your face, well, like things out of your face, you just can't do it. Get this one. It was open after the first one, wasn't it? Oh, the first one was a silver ring. Never mind me. Got hit. Wasn't paying attention, was looking at the box. Kill me. Oh, watch out for the mines! Shouldn't hit me from there anyway. Got clipped on the wing, but it doesn't bother me. Get as many of these as possible. Keep going, okay, no problem. There's a big bomb, clear out some enemies. Did I get them all? I see the scoreboard. We're obviously going to do this run quite a few times. We got in at the bottom. The bottom! Hooray! Last place. At least it's a place. That Thorntail guy is scrambling to get as near as possible.
You You got to help us. Those horrible sharp claws put out our lovely beacons, and it gets too dark at night. We be scared of the dark.
Okay, stop crying. I'll see what I can do.
Don't forget about the spellstone, Fox. You have to return it to the Force Point Temple.
Okay, Force Point Temple, helping crybabies that are scared of the dark. Jobs. So many jobs. A hero's job is never done, especially when he's been eaten by a gigantic dinosaur at one point, and then just flying back down to come to, light some fires at another. Ow! I don't remember them being so burny before. Are they like the frostweed in the fact that you heard them? Is that what you do with them? Even though it doesn't look like they can actually go far enough, to be honest. Ah, if you attack them, you can pick them up. This is a fireweed. It may come in use to help the Thorntails. So why couldn't I pick it up before? Better pick up a few of these, because obviously we need to do that in order to, well, sort everything out, sort the issues. We're going to war. Oh, I'm catching on fire from these things all the time. Okay, we got four of them now. So let's start on the beacons. Fireweed. Where are you on the list, sir? Place fireweed. And then...
flame.
Stay away from me. Do not burn me. And that is how you light the fires. So guys, I'm going to leave you there. It was a bit of a scrappy boss fight. I mean, I died, for goodness sake. I'm glad I had the perform dads, and I'm glad I had the perform dad holder, because of course now I've got multiple extra lives, but I wasn't expecting that to happen. My god, I was not expecting that to happen. That was a case of non-hand-holding in games. It didn't tell me what to do in any way, shape, or form. There was no obvious thing to do. For example, Zelda, it's usually use the item you find in the dungeon on the boss. I had no clue, just fight it. Random strategy. But yeah, it was still pretty epic. Gigantic dinosaur ate me, killed him from the inside. Good times, puked me out, great. But anyway guys, we're going to light the fires around this place for next episode. So for this one, see you around. Cheers for watching.